Hi everyone, my name is Sierra Barajas and I work on the design for repair team here at Microsoft. Surface Laptop 3 was the start of our journey across the portfolio to bring field repair closer to you, our customers. It was so exciting when Panos pulled the C cover off that device on stage during the announcement. And now I'm happy to show you the latest improvements in repairability by disassembling our newest Surface Laptop. This is the fifth generation of our original laptop, and we've worked to make it more repairable than ever before. I will be demonstrating a high-level disassembly and talking you through the new repairability features we've introduced. For full instructions on how to disassemble a device, please refer to the service guides that are posted on the Microsoft support site. The first step is to ensure that your device is shut down. We ask that users use the Windows system to shut down the computer completely before any repair. Once that's done, we can set up our station and our tools. Our workstation contains a grounded ESD work surface, and we should remove all jewelry and accessories for the duration of our work. The tools we will need are a plastic spudger, tweezers, 3, 5, and 6 IP Torx Plus screwdrivers. The first thing we're gonna do is remove the feet. So starting with the front feet, we'll insert the point of the spudger in here. Then we're gonna go into the channel and we can lightly lift up to help remove that foot. Next, I'll turn the device around and work on the back feet. While the front and the back feet are not the same, we're gonna use the same method to remove them. Once the feet are off, this exposes the screws underneath. We'll remove all 4 screws with a 5 IP driver, which will allow us to remove the keyboard assembly, also known as the C cover. Now we flip the device over and we can remove the C cover, which is attached via magnets. Depending on the device you have, you'll either have a metal or an Alcantara C cover. For the metal, we'll lift up the C cover near the display. For Alcantara instructions, please refer to the service manual since it's just a little bit different. Note that as you lift the C cover off, there might be a bit of resistance due to a thermal pad between the RSSD and the C cover, but there's also a cable connecting the C cover to the motherboard, so be gentle. Now we're gonna go ahead and disconnect this cable, trying not to touch the battery. Now we can safely disconnect the C cover and set it to the side, face down. Disconnecting the SSD shuts off the power to the whole device, so that's the next thing we're gonna wanna remove. Use the 5 IP driver to remove the 1 screw from the SSD. This will shut power off to the whole device and protect it during the repair. Depending on the configuration, you will also have to remove a foil sticker over part of the SSD. And then I'll go ahead and take this out. Note that once the repairs are complete, the power supply must be connected to the Surface Connect port of the device to enable the battery again. Once the SSD is removed, you can remove either the audio jack, Surface Connect port, thermal module, or AB cover. I've chosen to remove the AB cover first. Now onto the display assembly, known as the AB cover. We'll start by disconnecting the antenna on the AB cover next to the motherboard. Next, we'll use some tweezers to remove the RF baffles and the shields covering the AB to motherboard connectors. So these are our RF baffles. Next, we'll take some tweezers and move on to the shields. Once all the connectors are exposed, we'll gently disconnect them with a spudger. Okay, so those are all of our connectors. Using a 6 IP screwdriver, remove the screws on the left and right hinges of the AB cover, and it may need to be supported once the last screw is removed. Lift the AB cover at 90 degrees from the base and set to the side. Now we can work on removing the thermal module. Begin by removing the 6 3 IP screws that secure the thermal module to the rest of the device. Then disconnect the fan from the motherboard and remove the metal shield. There are four more screws to remove underneath that shield before the thermal module can be lifted out. While I work on these screws, I wanted to recognize the amazing work done by the team to make this device as repairable as it is today. We chose to focus on issues most likely to impact your experience to get you back to enjoying your device as soon as possible. Next, we removed the surface connect port. First, the screws on the metal bracket with a 3IP driver. Then the two screws holding down the port using the same driver. Finally, disconnect the latch of the surface port from the motherboard before removing the port from the unit. Now we remove the motherboard itself. Begin by removing the left bracket and their five screws. Once that is finished, remove two of the remaining metal shields to expose the screws underneath. Then go ahead and remove the remaining six 3IP screws holding down the motherboard. Next, we're going to disconnect the speakers. Finally, tilt the motherboard out and slide the I/O ports out of the frame. Set to the side. Next is going to be the audio jack. First, remove the 3IP audio jack screw, which will allow us to wiggle out that audio jack from the frame. And finally, the speakers, both left and right. Each of these parts is held down by three 3IP screws. The only thing remaining is our battery bucket subassembly, which is now looking pretty empty. When reassembling, always make sure to follow the service guide and count your screws to avoid having any free floating in the device, especially near the magnets or battery pack. As you can see, we now have a fully disassembled Surface Laptop 5. I hope you found this video useful. Check the Microsoft site for more information or to learn more about Microsoft's sustainability efforts.